Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm talking about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you're a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series, JavaScript Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about some of the most used inbuilt higher order functions in JavaScript: map, filter, and reduce. If you're not familiar about higher order functions, you can see my previous video about higher order functions. Okay, first, let us see about map function in JavaScript. Map function works only with the arrays. It creates an array by calling a specific function on each element present in the original array. In simple terms, the map function calls a function once for each element in an array. Sometimes you may need to take an array and apply some procedure to its elements so that you get a new array with modified elements. Instead of manually iterating over the array using a loop, you can simply use the built-in array.map method. Let me explain with a simple example. Let me create an array of few numbers. Now, my requirement is to create a new array in which I should have the squares of each number. If I want to find the square of a single number, I can create a function and accept the number as parameter and return the number multiplied by the same number. And so, if I console log, we can see the square of the number. But if we need to create an array with squares of all these numbers, we can do it like this. We can create a new function. In that function, we can get the array. We can have a new empty array, and then we can loop through the original array, and we can multiply each to find the square. And we can push that to the new array and return that. And so if I console log, we can see the new array with all the squares. But instead of doing all this, we can use map function to simplify our code. Let me show that. But first, let me explain how map works. When I add dot map on the original array, we can see it is expecting a callback function. Let me add a simple function which accepts a parameter, and let me print that inside. Now we can see it is iterating the array and printing one by one. So instead of printing, let me return the item and let me assign it to a variable and let me print the variable. Now we can see the original array. And so if I use item star item instead of item, we can see we got the desired output. So our code is simple now, but we can simplify further. Let me change this to an arrow function. Now also we can see the same output. And we know when there is only one statement, we can ignore the curly braces and return keyword. So let me remove those and bring it to a single line. If I execute, we can see it is still working. Okay, and finally, we can see this is what this function is returning. So instead of this, we can call this function. So we have reduced our code a lot. From this, we can understand map function is iterating over each element in the array and applying this function on each element and creating the new array. Okay, now let's see how we can use map function on an object array. Let me quickly create an array of objects. Now from this, I want to create a new array in which I need to have all the full names of each student. For that, I can use map like this. Let me assign this to a new variable and let me print that. So we can see it is giving us the array of full name of students. Hope you are clear about map function. Let's move to filter function. The filter method allows us to filter through an array, iterating over the existing values and returning only the ones that fit certain criteria into a new array. In simple terms, we can say A filter function in JavaScript is used to filter an array based on specific condition. Let me explain with a simple example. Consider this num array. From this, we need to filter and take out only the even numbers. For that, I can use the filter function like this. Here, it is iterating over each item and checking whether that is an even number. Only if it satisfies this condition, it pushes that item to the new array. So let me assign this into a new variable and let me print this. Now we can see only the even numbers. Similarly, if I want to filter the numbers less than 4, I can change the condition like this. So we can see only 1, 2, and 3. Okay, now we can see how we can use filter function to filter something from an object array. For that, let me take our student subject and add a new property, gender. Now our idea is to filter out only the boys. If we are not using filter function, we need to loop through each item using a for loop, and then we need to manually check whether the gender is male, and then based on that, we need to push that to a new array. But we can use a filter function like this very easily. Now we can see only the boys. I need to explain about one more concept before moving to reduce function. Now we are getting the object array here, but assume we need to get only the boy's first name. How can we get that? Actually, the good thing is we can chain multiple functions. So here, let me use a map function to get the first name of the boys. And so we can see only the names of the boys. Hope you understood about the use of filter function. Let's move to the reduce function. Actually, some developers struggle to understand the reduce function. The reduce function in JavaScript is used to reduce the array to a single value. Assume we have an array. Let's take our num array as an example. Now we need to find the sum of all the numbers in this num array. For this use case, we can use reduce function. To understand the reduce function easily, we need to see how we can solve this use case without using reduce function. Let me show that. First, we need to iterate over each item in this array. For that, we need to use a for loop, and then we need a temporary variable to store the sum. And inside the function, we add each number to the temporary variable and assign to the temporary variable itself. And finally, we can print this. And so we can see 15, which is the sum of all the numbers. Here we need to know two important variables. One, the temporary variable, we call this as accumulator, and the next one is each item. We call this as current value. So let's try to use reduce function. Let me create a new variable total sum equal to num array dot reduce. Here we need to have an accumulator and a current value. And inside the function body, we can use accumulator. In our previous code, it refers to term sum. So accumulator equal to accumulator plus current value. That's it. Finally, we need to return the accumulator. Now, if I print this total sum, we can see 15. So it is working. Let's quickly see another example. This time, we need to find the smallest number from an array. So let me change this to an array of different numbers. And let me rename this to min num, and this to min and item, so that it will be easy to understand. Here we are going to return the min. And before that, the logic is going to be, if item less than min, then min is equal to item. That's it. So if I execute, we can see 8. Hope you understood. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.